All right, so in this video, we're going to be talking about how we can directly connect our computer to our SkyCut machine via the USB cord that is given to us with our purchase, right? It's in the box. So this is probably the most common way that that folks are going to be doing it. It's a real simple process of all we have to do is connect. You're going to take a look at this blue cord here. That is the cord. Right now it's going into, you know, USB spots nowadays on computers. They are very limited. So I had to buy like a little port there for it. But anyways, that blue cord there, if we follow that blue cord all the way to the machine itself, you'll see that it is plugged into the center spot there. Okay, so you're noticing a couple ports there. We talked about that in another video, but the blue cord, that is the port that you're going to need to plug that into. Okay, that black cord that you see there is the power. Okay, so speaking of power, that's going to be the first thing that you're going to want to do with this is you're going to want to go ahead and power it up by clicking on the little circle there, that the power button. Okay, so once you hit the power button, it's going to turn on the screen, and now we're going to need to go into SkyCut a lot. Okay, so let's go ahead. I'm going to bring in our SkyCut a lot portion here, and things that you're going to want to go ahead and do anyway is we want to make sure that when we are setting ourselves up for success here, we want to make sure that our machine that we're cutting to is obviously the SkyCut. You will notice that our mat is gray in the top left corner. You will see the SkyCut being represented to you. Now, if you don't see this screen here, that is because you didn't watch our other video, which was how we're going to set it up with our My Cutter, Manage Cutters, and then SkyCut. Okay. Again, if you don't see yours in the drop-down menu, please watch that video. We go into, it's a quick 2-minute one. We go into detail on how to set that all up. Okay. Next thing is we need to go ahead and open up our library, and we need to at least put a shape on there so that we can test the connections out. And we're going to go ahead and choose, choose a heart here. I'm done with the library. I can close out a bit, and I'm just going to go ahead and make this a little bit bigger. And doesn't really matter for right now where I'm placing that. The next thing is once we have that, now it's time to go to the cutter, okay? And not the actual machine itself, okay? We are going to go into the cutter program. And we're going to notice a few things here. So we have the model, SkyCut, that's what we want to see. Connection type, we want USB, okay? So we click on USB, and then the port's going to be auto. And now we're going to go ahead and click on test connection. Now, when we click on test connection, this little menu will appear here. It says on here, this will attempt to move the rollers back and forth a short distance. And you should see this on your machine as well as hear it. So I'm going to go ahead and click on OK. And you can see that that head just did a quick little movement, okay? If you want to see it again a little bit bigger, we'll go ahead and do that. I'll go ahead and click on the test connection on my computer. And you can see it's very quick movement. That means we have a great, good connection there. And we can go ahead and proceed with actual cutting. And just to demonstrate real quick, again, you notice that I do not have a blade in there. Nothing is going to be cut. And it's not going to hurt the machine at all by not having a blade in there. And just running through this here real quick. And I'm going to go ahead and click on this origin point just so I don't have the mat shoot out at me. And again, I can choose the software to have the speed and pressure put in here. And then we're going to go ahead and hit cut. And then we should see that machine just go ahead and knock out that heart real quick. And you'll see that my cutting data has done and the machine is done as well. So that is the USB connection. Again, some of the pros and cons to this is, you know, pro is super duper easy to put in there, right? It's very easy to connect it to the computer, connect it to the plotter. Cons is if you're working, you know, with multiple people and they all want to use that machine, now if they want to cut with the USB, you have to pull it out of yours and put it into their machine, okay, or put it into their computer, okay. Again, it's a very common to go this way, but we are going to show you other ways that you can connect to it and it be wirelessly, okay. So make sure you follow along in those videos as well, okay. So take care.